Hello and welcome to this PalmSens unboxing video. I'm Lutz Stratmann and today I would like to show you what you get when you buy an EmStat4X. Let's immediately have a look into the box and afterwards we're going to do our first measurement with the EmStat4X. What do we find in the box? Well, the first thing is, and that's no surprise, an EmStat4X. In this case, you see this is the high range version. You can see that because it has the black bottom. We have here, as for comparison, the low range version. And you see the difference is this one has a connection for screen printed electrodes. But both of them come with an auxiliary port that is protected by a dust cap. Of course, both of them have battery and Bluetooth integrated. What else do you find? Well, you find your quick starts in there that help you to immediately get started. There's also your first measurement described in there, but if you don't want to read it, don't worry. This is exactly the measurement that we're going to do in this video. Okay, what else in the box? A USB-C cable, and it's USB-C to USB-C. And if your computer does not have a USB port, don't worry, we've put a little adapter to USB-A, which is the normal USB. Then of course, you will find a cable to connect your electrodes. It's our usual cable with the round plug in the front and the 2mm banana plugs here. The cable for the high range version of the EmStat4X has also a sense lead here, which is very important to always connect when you do your measurements. Usually you connect it to your working electrode. Okay, then of course you want to connect your electrodes, maybe by clipping your cables to the electrodes. So we have matching crocodile clips for your cable. Then you will also find in the box a dummy cell with three different circuits, which should help you to perform your first test measurements. Or maybe if you think, I think the instrument might not be working quite all right, you can use the test circuits to and just check out if your instrument is working as expected. Okay. And then we have a USB stick with our software PSTrace on it, so you can easily install it directly. But don't worry if you find that a bit old-fashioned. We also have an activation code in there that you can use to open up an account on our download website, so you can download the software. Now, we have unboxed our EmStat4X, except I would like to point out the second dummy cell that you will get if you order an EmStat4LR, because it has also the screen printed electrode connector, and so you get a dummy cell that matches that as well. For the people who are already fans of the EmStat4S, here is a comparison in size between the EmStat4X and the EmStat4S. We now know what we get when we bought our EmStat4X. Let's have a look at our first measurement with an EmStat4X. I have already installed PSTrace and open it, and I'm also removing the USB cable because we're going to connect our EmStat4X via Bluetooth. Okay, so first let's start by connecting our cable. You look on your plug for the red dot, and that one has to point upwards when you connect it to your EmStat4X. Then, as I said, you should connect your working electrode to the sense lead, which is marked white. Then we need for our dummy cell the crocodile clips. The red one for the working electrode, I connect the blue one for the reference electrode, and I connect the black one for the counter electrode. Then I'm taking my dummy cell, and for this measurement, I'm going to choose the 10 kilo ohm resistor, that is the working electrode B, on our dummy cell. So I connect the working electrode to working electrode B. I connect the blue reference electrode to the reference electrode pad, and the black counter electrode to the counter electrode pad. I just need to do one more thing. I switch on now my EmStat4X. For that, I just need to hold that button. I want to connect via Bluetooth in PSTrace, so I need to know which device is my device. In the screen of the EmStat4X, you find here the number of your EmStat4X that you will select in the Bluetooth menu. Let's have a look how that looks like. So here's PSTrace. In the top left, you find the Bluetooth button that will start the search for any Bluetooth devices. Once it has found all the Bluetooth devices, it will list them here in this drop-down menu. Let's have a look what it found. I know my number is the PSF46F, so I'm selecting that one and I press connect. Now it has connected to the EmStat4X. You can also see that in the screen of the EmStat4X. Now it has this little Bluetooth icon. For my first measurement, I want to have it very easy and convenient. I'm choosing from the method menu, the load option, and then I am choosing PS dummy cell LSV 2 volt, and PSTrace automatically loads all the settings that I need here into the menu. Press run the measurement and the measurement starts. This measurement is just a linear sweep voltammetry on a 10 kilo ohm resistor, so we're expecting a diagonal line, and this is what we got here. Now we know our EmStat4X is working properly. We've already done our first measurement and we are good to go to explore all its function further. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss any future videos, and follow us on LinkedIn so you don't miss any of our updates. Have a great day and thanks for watching.